Hallelujah. We're back to our fully
Hallelujah.
online services, but let us pray that you will come back to the church again soon. As just as the elder has prayed,
so today
we're going to continue on with the Romans studies. And Romans, this is the 14th lesson in the book of Romans.
尽快，就如刚才长老祷告，希望我们可以尽快回到教会去做礼拜。
Today we're going to cover the entire chapter. Of course, we cannot cover in detail verse by verse, but let us think about what Apostle Paul is teaching us about the law and me.
那我们要继续罗马的课。
Sin and law.
所以我们继续罗马书的课，就让我们先看罗马书第七章第一至三节。罗马书第七章
，Chapter seven, verses one through three. Or do I? Do you know?
也说，弟兄们，我现在对明白律法的人说。我们既不晓得律法管人是在活着的时候吗？
如
女人有了丈夫，丈夫还活着，就被律法约束。丈夫若死了，就脱离了丈夫的律法。所以丈夫活着，他若归于别人，便叫淫妇。丈夫若死了，他就脱离了丈夫的律法，虽然归于别人，也不是淫妇。
We live under some kind of law. Everybody, if we say we are free, we are under some kind of law.
在这世上呢，我们每个人都必须符合一定的律法。可能说我们不需要符合律法，可是呢，居住在这个世界上，我们打个比喻，就是这个地心引力的律法啊，大自然的律法等等。使徒保罗在今天主要经文中，主要经文中所说的这个丈夫，说到我们的天父。
There is also the law of the Old Testament that Apostle Paul speaks of, which God gave us.To release us,
那神给我们律法是为了要让我们明白自己的罪在哪里。自己的罪是在哪里
？God is helping us to realize what kind of sin we are living with, and so that we can have the desire to get away from that sin.And then there's the law of grace that releases us from
the bondage of sin and frees us. So what
kind of law is ruling over us today? And we might want to say, I want to be under the law of grace, but let us ask ourselves, as we read in the Bible, Paul said, I live in God's grace. What kind ofLife do I live, and what do I obey?
我们要问自己，我居住在什么律法下，而我服从的是什么律法？我们要考虑到，自由。神要把我们从罪中，从最终释放出来。那神为什么要给我们这个自由呢？那我们继续读罗马书第七章第四到第六节。
我
的弟兄们， 这样说来，你们借着基督的身体，在律法上也是死了，叫你们归于别人，就是归于那从死里复活的，叫我们结果子给神。为我们属肉体的时候，那因律法而生的恶念就在我们肢体中发动，以致结成死亡的果子。但我们既然在困我们的律法上死了，现今就脱离了律法，叫我们不是主，要按着心灵的新样，不按着遗文的旧样。阿们。
We used to bear fruit of death, but now we are released from the law.
所以这个经文清楚地说，我们已经在律法上被释放出来，脱离了律法，心灵的新样是服侍神。所以神给我们自由，是要让我们能够为他结果子。你和我呢，是脱离了罪的约束的人，我们不再受到律法的这个管辖。神这么做是要让你和我可以为他结果子。那今天你是自由人吗？你是已经脱离了罪的这个捆绑吗？而如果你是自由人，你结了什么样的果子呢？你有为神结好的果子吗？还是你仍然在罪下？有永生的果子。
Basically, the gift that we are receiving,
我们要得的就是这永生的果子，对吗？
So that as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness, leading to eternal life.
罗马书第五章二十一节说，
Hebrews 11 verse 16 also tells us that we
就如罪作王叫人死，照样恩典也借着义作王，叫人因我们的主耶稣基督得永生。那在加拉太书第五章二十二节里面呢？第五章二十二节和二十三节说，我们要结这些果子。圣灵所结的果子就是仁爱、喜乐、和平、忍耐、恩慈、良善、信实、温柔、节制。这样的事没有法禁止，所以我们必须要结果子。我们要全心的做一个好的信徒。那如果你是一个好的人，那你还需要律法来管辖你吗？不需要，为你是在律法之上。这并不表示你可以遵守律法，而是说你已经再也不需要被律法管辖着，因为你是一个重新都结这些好的果子的人。所以今天让我们问自己吧，我是否有这一些的果子呢？有吗？像我们所说到的圣灵所结的果子，就是仁爱、喜乐、和平、忍耐、恩慈、良善、信实、温柔、节制。这九个果子我们有没有？
Secondly, he said the reason why he set us free from the bondages of sin is so that we can serve in the new.
另外呢，为什么神要给我们自由？为我们，他要我们
按这新灵的新样，不按这异闻的旧样来，服侍神。所以新样在希腊文是 kainos。
In secular usage, kainos denotes that that
which is kainos 的意思呢，就是
What has existed until now?
跟现在拥有的比较起来是新的，这并不是一个我们出世以来就有的东西，而是神给我们的一个礼物。这并不表示我们出世就有这样东西，而是神给我们的一个礼物。
These are the things that I might not have been born with.
虽然我不是一出世以来就有了这个，就有了这些圣灵的果子。可是神他赐福给我们。
Whereas naos is used temporarily, meaning.Time-wise, like yesterday is old and today is old.
在时间上的一个观念，怎么讲呢？就是昨天是旧的，今天是新的。可是昨天是旧的，今天是新的，可能是同样的一个东西。可是，在圣经里面呢，当他说到新样，不是 veios， 而是 kainotes，也就是说。在品质上是新的，是不同的。
In other words, new because
就是从里面打从里面成为一个新的人，你的心、你的灵已经改变了。你的心、你的灵全部完全改变。
Right, what we eat comes out. You know, just.I think I gave this example before.
一个很好的例子是呢，你吃什么？你吃多了，你就会有那个味道。好像我们韩国人每次都是吃泡菜，所以我们有泡菜的味道。
Smell like what we eat. Spiritually also, we have the illumination. We have.
所以属灵的一样，如果你犯许多罪。
Even if we are,
你就会有这个罪的这个气味。就说你是外表呢，假装在称颂神，可是所出现的都是跑的，就是有罪的气息。可是如果你有圣灵在你里头，你所
God has given us that freedom in Jesus.To receive the Spirit, to act upon
the Spirit, 你所呈现的这个气味呢是好的气味，而你可以。
The new way. Before I used to serve with my own zeal, with my gifts and talents, with my thoughts, but now the Spirit comes upon us. It's not by the written code, not by the letter, it's not by the field manual.It's by the Holy Spirit. That doesn't mean against the rule or against the guidelines, but more so according to God's ways. So I pray that not only when we lead worship or preach or do Bible studies or pray in the church, but every day, the things that we do, the things that we say,
我希望呢，每天我们所做的事都能够跟随圣灵，那会多么好！那使徒保罗他有给我们解释律法的功能，为什么神要给我们律法？首先，律法让我们明白到罪是什么。没有律法，我们就不明白什么是罪。
What then shall we say? That the law is sin? By no means. It's not the law.
罗马书第七章第七节说：“这样我们可说什么呢？律法是罪吗？断乎不是。”只是非因律法，我就不知为何为罪。
非律法说不可起贪心，我是不知可为贪心。还有罗马书第七章第八节说，我以前没有对不起，然而会趁着机会就借着律诫命叫诸般的贪心在我心里发动，因为没有律法罪是死的。
Produced in me all kinds of covetousness. So the law says, do not covet. And so Paul realized coveting is sin. And then he realized,
那律法使保罗发现原来贪心是罪。
For apart from the law, sin lies dead. But because of the law, the sin is coming alive. What he's saying is, because of the law,I realized that sin is in there.
那他是在说，其实之前呢，我有罪，可是我却不知道。律法使我明白到了啊，原来我的心里面充满了贪心和贪婪，而这一切都是罪。所以有很多人不喜欢听道，因为道使他们醒悟到自己是一个罪人。他们宁可不知。
Ignorance is a bliss. When we didn't know what sin was, when we didn't know what we.
因为他们可能觉得无知甚好。
Children of God, weren't we so happy and joyous? We lived in a bliss, but.Of course, the end of that ignorant bliss.
当然，如果你无知的话，你就会到最后你不会受审。
Not only does the law tell us what sin is, and also lets us know that that sin is in me, but it helps us to get rid of that sin.
所以呢，当我们明白到律法，律法使罪变成死的，这是在罗马书第七章九到十一节。我以前没有律法是活着的，但是诫命来到，罪又活了，我就死了。那本来叫人活的诫命，反倒叫我死，因为罪趁着机会就借着诫命引诱我，并且杀了我。所以他是在说些什么呢？他是在说，其实你本来不明白到你自己有病。
But when you put a microscope on you, and you see through it, you realize, ooh,
本来你不能明白自己有病，可是当你用这个放大镜来看自己的手等等，你发现到自己有很多细菌在身上。
Sin came alive and I died. The very commandment that promised life proved to be death to me. It can be taken in two ways. He says, I just basically died realizing how sinful I am, basically lost all my hope because I'm such a great sinner.And also, he,
那在这里呢，保罗他明白到
I died, meaning, my sins,
他自己的罪
the law told me that I am
而他的罪导致他死亡。
Verse 11, for sin, seizing an opportunity through the commandment, deceived me.
所以呢，使徒保罗说因为罪趁着机会就借着诫命引诱我，就而并且杀了我。第十二节，这样看来，律法是圣洁的，律诫命也是圣洁、公义两善的。所以使徒保罗他在告白的是呢，他知道说其实律法是好的，而律法使我醒悟到中的一切罪。
The law is good.
我不怪律法，律法是好，可是我是不好的。
I am the bad one.
使徒保罗说，明白律法之前，
I came to realize
之前呢，他并不知道罪是什么。明白了律法之后，他知道他是一个罪人，他不能够以自己的力量生活存，他只能够寻神的宽恕，求神的怜悯来生活。
Only comes when the old dies. The newness comes when we die to sin. And I think this you might understand when COVID-19 first began. This is something that I heard from a doctor. Something that I thought I knew, but when he said it,
他说当这个新冠状病毒刚现实
he said COVID-19, this virus.Can survive
我听到了一个
living,
医生说这句话
dies,、
他说什么呢他说新冠状病毒只能够在活人的身上生活着
so, saying,
生存着、
like、
如果这个人死这个人死这个新冠状病毒就不能够在他的身上存活那这如果我们拿来和罪相比怎么说呢那
它
表示如果我们人
死了
就是说如果我们对罪的这个态度是死的我们就不这个罪就不会继续生存在我们的心中
Is it greed? Is itsexual temptation,
不管你
games, money,
犯的罪是什么
lying,
撒谎也好贪婪也好
that temptation
如果你这些罪对你来说是死了那这个罪就不可以继续在你的心中存活
Under the law, his sin only became greater,
在律法下呢
罪
变得越来越大怎么讲呢因为律法是让我们可以看得到罪的一样东西好像一个放大镜律法批准我们明白到罪是多么的、污秽在罗马书第七章十三节里面说七章十三节既然如此那良善的叫我死吗断乎不是叫我死的乃是罪但借着那良善的叫我死就显出真是罪叫罪因着诫命更显出是恶极了所以
That's deep. So,
一本说来使徒保罗是在对我们说神的律法把罪明显的显出给我们看当我们看到这个罪时我们要做些什么呢
When that virus is revealed, we turn on lights,
打个比喻、忽然间你你进厨房
you know, feast,
开灯的时候
kitchen,
你就看得到一只小强
watching,
这个蟑螂跑掉
you know, so、you walk in and turn on the light and the cockroaches are feasting on your food and that kills you, you die but then cockroaches are revealed
当你打开灯你可以看得到那个蟑螂在你的厨房里面当然你看到你会吓到对吗吓死你了可是呢你看到那只蟑螂有灯看到那只蟑螂你就可以抓它你就可以把它、除灭所以同样的这个律法就像是光让我们可以看得到罪让我们可以把这个罪去除掉他说我还非常不、习惯通过网络做礼拜因为我看不到你们的样子所以我也不知道说你们听得明白我说的话吗我只能够布道
道，希望你们可以明白，你们有领受到这个道。
But then I come to grace and I am born again. I died my old self.
但我们人在心中常常会有这个，就罗马书第七章十六节说。
Now if I do what I do not want, I agree with the law.
做我所做的是我所不愿意的，我就应承律法是善的。
But the evil I do not want is what keeps on doing, what I keep on doing.
所以呢，使徒保罗说，我知道什么是好的，我也想要行善。
But then somehow,
可是呢，很多时候我却做不出来，反而呢。我不想做的坏，我一直做那个坏的。罗马书第七章十九节，故此我所愿意的善，我反不做；我所不愿意的恶，我倒去做。
The spiritual eyes are open to see what is good and what is not good, and you want to do good. But is that the case with you?Do we always do good, or is there something or somebody in me that seems to be controlling and leading more?
那我们想要做好的。
I'm wanting to do good, but
可是呢，我们想要做好的，可是我们却常常做不好的。
Verse 21.
二十一节。
I find it to be a law that when I want to do right.
我觉得有个律，就是我愿意为善的时候，便有恶与我同在。
Whenever I try to do good, there's that much more evil lies close at hand. I now want to do good and right? So Apostle Paul is showing us step by step the progress. He lived in sin without knowing what sin was.Without understanding that he was a sinner, but the law allowed him to understand that he's a sinner, and the law allowed him to even, by the grace of Jesus, even die to sin.
使徒保罗说，律法使他明白到罪是什么。律法使他。
Even though we want to follow the good, it's not happening somehow.
使他明白到什么是。对，什么是错？可是呢，他说他想要行好的，却行不到。罗马书第七章二十一、二十二节，我觉得有个律，就是我愿意为善的时候，便有恶与我同在。因为按着我里面的意识，我是喜欢神的律，所以。
And making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. 交战 still in there.
继续交战，就是神的律法。
So he says, "Wretched man that I am, I'm torn in between. I feel like schizophrenic."
罗马书第七章二十三到二十五节。但我觉得肢体中另有个律和我心中的律交战，把我拐去，叫我服从。那肢体中犯罪的律，我真是苦啊！谁能救我脱离这取死的身体呢？感谢神，靠着我们的主耶稣基督就能脱离了。这样看来，我以内心顺服神的律，我肉体却顺服罪的律了。所以哪一个才是真正的我呢？要行善的，还是不行善的呢？
How do you define? How do you decide which one is really you? You might say, I continue to want to do good. But then if you don't do good all the time,
那
that, maybe that's the real you.
这个心中的交战到底哪一个律法
rules over you? Which one do you obey?
到底哪一个律带领你呢？是神的律法
is the one that does not want to do bad, And once having the desire,
想要行善的
is that the real you?
而不想行恶的，哪一个才是真正的你呢？
Apostle Paul, I use the analogy of the virus. I'll do that again. When a bad virus comes into us, we do the things that we don't want to do, like coughing, having fever. That's not,
得了这个不好的病毒，我们会咳嗽，我们会流鼻水。那病毒进入我们的身体，其实我是不想要有这种病症，对吗？可是我会开始发烧、咳嗽等等。
That's what Apostle Paul is saying. I don't want to do it, but somehow that law of sin is still in me. I cannot get out of this.
我不希望得病，可是我却不能够去除这个病。
My body is not listening to me.So what do we do? Apostle Paul is actually saying,
保罗其实在说这是个好的东西。
You and I think it's a bad thing because I want to do good and my life, my body is not doing good. But Apostle Paul is saying, it's a good thing because before,
那使得保罗说这是一个好，为什么？因为之前我根本就不知道，在还没有律法和耶稣的恩惠之前，我根本就不知道我的心里面正在交战。
Oh, wretched man that I am! The fact that I can realize that I am a wretched man is a good thing. Who will deliver me from this body of death? So now he's seeking for a way to be delivered. When you find out that there's virus that's killing you.What are you going to do? What do? We look for some kind of medicine, shots, vaccination, something that will help me to live, help me to get rid of that virus. So that's the next step. We need to fight.
使徒保罗是在说，现在你明白到自己心中有这个交战挣扎，所以你就必须要抗拒它。
And as reference, but let us read verse 25 into
this main
passage. And that's the last verse in chapter 7.
罗马书第七章24-25节。我真是苦啊，谁能救我脱离这取死的身体呢？感谢神，靠着我们的主耶稣基督就能脱离了。这样看来，我与内心顺服神的律，我肉体却顺服罪的律了。
It was a bad thing that there's a conflict, but Apostle Paul says, "Hey, there's a conflict because now I have this immunity."I used to just
使徒保罗说，现在呢，我
I used to just give in and give up to the virus.
现在我明白到了
immune cells in me, and so I'm fighting.
中有这个交战。
I know it's not good. I know still my body still does the bad, but I know at least I know.
虽然我仍然做许多不好的事，可是至少现在我明白到什么是不好的，这表示我的免疫力越来越强，我的抵抗力越来越强。所以呢，当我们读到使徒保罗说罗马书第七章24节，他说我真是苦啊。
Before we didn't even know, but the best medicine is.
谁能救我脱离这取死的身体呢？
Although I'm being defeated day by day, thanks be to God. Because I know I'm not perfect yet, but Jesus gained victory.
那耶稣会帮助我们。
Jesus will help me. So, if there's anyone who feels Like、
所以呢，这个增加我们免疫力、抵抗力最强的东西是什么？就是感恩。
Temptation and gossip or said bad things or you know.
我们要增加我们的免疫力，我们要充满感恩。而今天，如果我们做了不好的事， 如果我们对人发脾气，如果我们有贪婪之心，如果我们有恨，那让我们来忏悔，让我们来向神忏悔祷告，希望神的恩惠会进入我们的心中。你和我呢，是好像飞机一样，怎么说呢？会飞机必须要起飞，飞机必须要起飞，飞机必须要很快的就。
We might say, I'm doing well in this world. I'm better than this. I'm better than that.
飞机要起飞，要进，要快的。
What's the use? What is Jesus wanting?
好像走然后起飞，对吗？那耶稣给我们自由，就是要我们可以这么做。
And what is holding us down?
到底在我们的生命中有什么事情使我们
through the Holy Spirit? That's when we live by the Holy Spirit, when we see the blessing of the Holy Spirit, get fired up in the Word, it is like airplane taking off, finally off.
有什么东西使我们被锁在这个地上呢？耶稣要我们做的是要我们能够成功的起飞，所以让我们看有什么东西是阻止我们起飞的。我们要把这些也不好的东西都去除，放弃你的罪，放弃你的不好的习惯，你要放这一切。
Then you will be able to fly. And once you experience flying in the Lord, meaning really flying with the Holy Spirit,
你要在主里面起飞。
That is a real walk of faith.
这才是真正的。
So I pray, let us pray.
与神同行。所以千万不要放弃。到底。为我们的，现在我们要一起祷告，为我们的兄弟姐妹祈祷，还有把自己的罪都呈现在神的面前，求他的原谅，为我们的教会，为我们的国家祈祷。希望我们可以花差不多30秒或一分钟的时间来为我们的国家祷告，因为现在
just such a short period of time,
我们又不可以回到教会，让我们来为这个新冠状病毒这个状况祷告，希望一切可以尽快的进步，有进步。所以现在让我们来大家肃静的祈祷。亲爱的天父，我们感谢你，因为你知道我们的软弱，你知道我们的罪孽，可是你仍然接受我们，你仍然怜悯我们，就如使徒保罗他所说的，啊，我真是苦啊，虽然我们知道什么是好的，可是我们却不做。天父，请你救我们，给我们属灵的免疫力，给我们属灵的抵抗力。希望耶稣基督在十字架上的胜利也能够给予我们胜利。我们以耶稣圣名祷告，阿门。让我们鼓掌来荣耀神，谢谢大家。